Hello, students, teachers, and maybe some parents. I am Miss Yazz, a science teacher from the Palo Alto Junior Museum and Zoo. We love coming into your schools and your classrooms and bringing science activities to you there. We really miss doing that right now, and we are thinking about all of you. Today, I'm going to share a science investigation with you, and I want you to join me with this. Play along. So, before we begin, each student should gather a small pitcher or large measuring cup of water, three or more different shaped cups or bowls, a large plate or a tray with sides if you have one, and a small towel. All right. If you need a few minutes to get these things, you can pause the video right now to gather the supplies that you need. So, today we are going to explore liquids. What is a liquid? How do we know that we have a liquid? Okay, how do we know when we have one? So, sometimes it's easier to understand something when we compare it to something different. I have two almost cubes here in front of me. One is ice, a solid that I can pick up and hold in my hand, and it stays cube-shaped, all right? The other is liquid water in a cube-shaped glass container. What happens if I try to pick up the water without the container? I really can't do it, okay? I can touch the liquid and I can feel it because it's made of matter, it's made of stuff, but I can't pick it up with my fingers because its stuff, its matter, is not attached together the same way as the solid. Okay? When I try to pick up the liquid with my fingers, the liquid just flows down and away. So we've learned some things about liquids already. Liquids are made of matter, they're made of stuff, and liquids can flow or pour. Okay? So two things we've already learned about liquids in that little brief moment. I'm going to put my solid aside. We might play with it again later. And we'll play with the liquid. The liquid that I'm using here is water from the sink. I added some color to it just so it would be easier to see on the video. Water is great for experimenting with because it is safe and it's pretty easy to clean up. The towel. All right. Let's get ready to try some things with the water. I hope you have your own pitcher of water and some cups or bowls nearby for you to use. So I'm going to get my water into my pitcher. Okay. I'm going to put this guy aside. Okay, so I have my pitcher of water and some cups or bowls to use. So I'm using glass so that you can see what I'm doing, but really, it is okay to use any kind of cups or bowls that you have at home, okay? They will be fine. You don't have to be able to see through them. You can use what you have. So before you begin, you should get the materials that you need. Have your cups and your bowls and a towel close by. Make sure that the computer or tablet or phone that you are using to watch this video on is someplace away from the water so that it won't get wet, okay? Before you do a science experiment, it's always important to make sure your workspace is tidy and safe. Working on a tray is a good idea. If you don't have a tray, you can even just put your towel down on the table and work on the towel. Let's pour the water into some different cups and bowls, okay? I found some glass containers that have interesting shapes and that I'm going to show you, but you can use any cups or bowls that you have at home, right? And so we can pour the water and just kind of look at it, see what happens. Look at them together. All right. Yeah. All right. So you can pour them together, look at them, or you can pour them from one into another cup. If, you know, when I look at these, The water, it looks like the shape of the cup that it is in, okay? The shape of the water changes when I put it into different containers. Now, I'm gonna bring back for a brief moment my ice, that's solid, and we're gonna see if changing the container that I put the solid in changes the shape of the ice. It didn't, right? It really didn't care that I put it into this container. That didn't change its shape. I can try putting it in, oh, here's a different one. I can try putting it in this container. Still isn't changing its shape, okay? Because it's a solid, it has a shape, and it keeps its own shape. Now you can look around your house and find other containers later, because maybe now you'll find containers that are different other fun shapes. Check in with your parents about it before you use them. This has led us to think about one more thing about liquids. All right, so another thing we can learn about liquids. Liquids do not have their own shape. Liquids take the shape of the container that they're in, okay? And if they're not in a container, if we spill a liquid, like I did a little bit, that happens, it just ends up being kind of a puddle shape or something, right? It doesn't really have its own shape, okay? Now we're gonna try something else with the liquid. So I'm actually gonna put it back into here for a minute. So I want you to have your three cups or bowls empty right here. And I want you to look at them and by looking at them, decide which one is the smallest one of those three, okay? So this one's the smallest of these. So I'm gonna start with this one, okay? The smallest cup. So you're going to fill your smallest cup with water, whichever one is your smallest cup. Go ahead and fill it with water, and as carefully as you can, get it full, but you don't necessarily want it to spill over. Fill your small cup with water, okay? So you see that? That's filled up. Now, take that small cup and pour it, it can be a little tricky, pour it into a different cup, okay? Different cup or bowl, and look at that. And then you can take that water and pour it into your third cup or bowl. All right, different. It's got a lot more room. Then finally, take your third cup and pour it back into the small cup that you started with. Okay. And we see when we do that, that we basically ended up with the same amount of liquid that we started with, that we have the same volume as when we began. That's if you were careful and not too much spilled out. Your cup should be filled up the same way that it was when you started. Okay. I'm gonna do that again with some different containers, with some special containers, and we're gonna learn some things about that. So I'm gonna move these off to the side. I'm using this special cup that has markings on it, and it's a measuring cup, and I'm going to put water in it so that I start with 500 milliliters of water, okay? So I've measured out 500 milliliters of water. And now I'm going to play with some different kinds of containers. I'm going to bring back that cube container that we had at the beginning, and I'm going to pour my 500 milliliters of water into that cube container. Okay. And then from the cube container, I'm going to pour into another kind of container. This one's hard to pour from. That one, pour it into a different shaped container. Yeah, the same amount of water every time. Pour it into a different shaped container. more. Big cube. All right, that water, all that fun water, those fun liquids. Now, let's go back into my measuring cup. Okay, back into my measuring cup with markings. And let's see how much water we have. It is still, and it always has been, 500 milliliters of water. There. So we have one more thing to add to our traits about water. Okay, one more thing that we've now learned about liquids. Liquids have a defined volume. So what that means is that they take up as much space as they take up, okay? They do not expand or get bigger in a bigger container, okay? Gases will do that. I'm not gonna talk about them much today, but that's something special about liquids. So we've learned lots of things about liquids today, just playing with them, moving them around in different containers. I'm gonna review what we learned today about liquids. Liquids are made of matter, okay? They're made of stuff. They can flow or pour. They do not have their own shapes. They take the shape of the container that holds them. They have a defined volume and do not expand in a bigger container. Thank you for joining me to explore the science of liquids together today. Keep exercising your brain to keep it strong, and take care.